So this is my latest book, Siren, and it's number 5 in the Mackaydee Vanderwall series. And in this book, I think I've really put her through more than I have in any previous novel with Mac. So I give her a pretty hard time. And of course, the research I do for my novels is part of the excitement for me. I try to do something a little bit crazy for every book. In Siren, that means that I was set on fire and choked unconscious. I'm sure every novelist does that for their books, right? I had the most extraordinary experience with an ultimate fighter named Big John McCarthy in the States. And I had to step into the ultimate fighter octagon with him, knowing he was going to choke me unconscious. And it was an absolute spin-out, but really necessary for the scene in the book that features a chokehold. I guess I'm a novelist that likes to write about what they know, and I like to know new things all the time, so hence I'm quite motivated to go out and have new experiences. And the interesting thing about being choked unconscious was that Big John wanted to do it as carefully as one can, which is a very good thing, but it means that he did it quite slowly, and the problem, of course, was that because he was choking me out slowly, I had a whole stretch of time where I was awake and conscious and couldn't breathe, and it hurt. And that was, I wouldn't say one of the scariest moments of my life, but it was certainly one of the most uncomfortable moments of my life. It's a stretch of time where this man, whose biceps are bigger than my whole head, had his arm around my neck and was choking me. And all I could think was, I'm still awake. Why am I still awake? You know, I can feel this. I can feel this. I can't breathe. My eyes are bulging out of my head. You know, every molecule of my being is in alarm mode, screaming that I don't have any oxygen going to my brain. And yet, I've put my hand up for this, and I'm hoping and waiting for the moment of being unconscious. I think without having that experience, I couldn't have written this particular scene in the book the way that I did. So, as mad as that might be, it's really necessary for me as a writer, and that's my style of writing. It's experiential. The other experience I had, of course, was being lit on fire, which was arguably more dangerous. It was quite controlled, of course, but I hadn't realized that after 15 seconds, your skin melts. So I went out with a stunt company in Los Angeles, and all these stunties were telling me how it was going to work, being set on fire, and they covered me in aloe, which cools the skin, and then covered me in a fire retardant gel, then put on this fire retardant kind of jersey, which is the same material they use underneath the race car driving suit. So I was familiar with that from getting my race car driver's license. And I'm here in this jersey just lubed up with all this gel. And they put a couple of bits of flammable gel on there and lit me on fire. And, you know, looking at the seconds as they pass, knowing that at 15 seconds I'm going to start melting even underneath all of that fire retardant protection. And the wildest thing was that it took like 8 seconds to even feel the heat. My face, I felt it, because there's a flame that's sitting this high coming off of my body, but I didn't actually feel it on my skin because of all the aloe and everything. And at 12 seconds, they just hosed me down, and it was over. And I remained kind of warm and red under all the stuff for like the rest of the day. And after being choked out, I felt like I'd been punched in the throat, and it was bruised for like 24 hours afterwards. I gotta say though, these experiences, they really, they inspire me. They're part of the reason why I want to write crime, because I can research these things. I'll do basically whatever it takes to research the scenes in my book.
Ready?
Oh God.
Here okay. We start to go.
Yeah.